What's up, everybody? It's update time over here in our garden. I want to thank everyone for joining us. All right, everybody, we're standing in front of our veg tent right now. And back there, we have two girls in, I think, number two pots growing in cocoa. Those are Girl Scout cookies. I chopped them about, I chopped off a foot off the top of them. So they were already hitting the light. So I chopped them down a little bit, took some cuttings. Got them right there. Also got some SFEOG cuttings in there. So we should start seeing roots in, I think, 5-6 days from now. Over here in the front of the tent, we got two SFEOGs. These two girls right here, they're gonna be in here, I think, 2-3 more weeks, and then these will be the next girls to fill out the scrog. Everything's looking pretty good, pretty healthy in there. Let's go up to the fire tent. Alright, everybody. We're right now standing in front of our flower tent. And we got a little bit more room in here because we took down two girls, the two SFEOGs we had in cocoa. They were in number five pots. They got harvested during the week after 2 weeks of flush. And the only thing we got left in here is three plants in DWC buckets. 1, 2, 3. And now this girl right here, she's been flushing for 4 days now. She's gonna keep flushing for maybe another week. And that girl over there, she's going to receive nutrients for, I believe, another 2 weeks at least before she starts getting flush. This girl right here, she just began her third week of flower. And it's definitely time to lollipop her. Clean all that shit up. Got to do that tonight. So I'll get around to doing that tonight. And as far as those girls that I just harvested, I'm going to talk about the flush and how that goes, because when you're flushing a plant, you know, in cocoa, it's really fucking labor intensive. It's a long process. It just fucking sucks. I really don't like doing that shit. It's a must, but just the amount of water that has to go, you know, you have to fucking waste to get your runoff to read less than 100 parts per million is pretty incredible. They were growing in a number five pot, so I ran through 13 gallons of water per pot just to get it down below 100 parts per million. They at the end of the flush, it was around 40, 45 parts per million, and I was happy with that. So I quit when I got to like 40 parts per million. And I just, you know, I was just happy with that. And like I said, it's just, it takes so much fucking water, you know. And, you know, the first fucking day that I start the flush, you know, it's real flush, you know, I run like 4 or 5 gallons of water through it. You know, then the next day I do the same thing. On the third day, then I, you know, just run 3 gallons of water to, you know, through the pot. I have a tote underneath the 5 gallon pots, and that's where I collect the water. Then I pump it into buckets and dump it outside or whatever. So it definitely is a process. And, you know, when you're growing in DWC, the flush is just so easy. You do your rest change, you know, your weekly rest change, and that's it. You know, if you're gonna flush for more than a week, then you just do another rest change, you know, of straight RO water, and you're fucking flushing, you know, and it's fast. It's a fast flush. Usually within a week, you're gonna get your plant fairly yellow, you know, as opposed to the cocoa plants. It takes about 2-2.5 weeks to really yellow them out. Just, you know, what I noticed in, you know, growing in different mediums is, rock wool is a little bit easier to flush. You don't need to run as much water through it to to get your runoff below 100 parts per million. Coco, it seems to take quite a bit of water to get that runoff down. So let me show you guys some frost shots of this sprog plant that's flushing. Very frosty. Really, really happy with that fucking plant. Let me show you guys this girl over here. She has another 2, maybe 3 weeks to go receiving nutrients, but she's frosting up very well for us. So she's coming along pretty nicely. So, you know, in order to produce frost like this, one of my friends asked me, well, how do you get them so fucking frosty? And I didn't just start getting plants frosty like this. It's a gradual improvement. You know, it all has to do with overall plant health. From veg all the way to flower, you want no fucking problems, you want no deficiencies, nothing like that to hinder the plant's health. Once you achieve that is when you really start packing on this frost, you know? It's when plants start looking like this. I told them that's how I get them this fucking frosty, you know? I have a steady nutrient regimen that I give them. They stay healthy, you know. That is the most important thing that I would have to say in order to get this kind of frost is overall plant health, from fucking clone straight through to flower. You want no problems whatsoever, you know. You don't want shitty looking, sad looking clones. You want vigorous, healthy looking clones. You want vigorous, healthy-looking plants in veg as well as in flower. And that's how you're going to guarantee that you're going to produce quality stuff and incredible frost like this. So that's basically my tip to him, is what I told him. Overall plant health. So that's pretty much what's going on over here in our garden. Let's finish this off with a dab. I want to show you guys what we're dabbing on. We got more than a couple flavors to choose from today, but we're going to go with this Flame Walker cake batter. All right, everybody, get them nails ready. Heat up them bangers. Let's dab up. We better for sure, like never before, come back to settle the score, a casualty of war. We better for sure, like never before, come back to settle the score, a casualty of war. We better for sure. If I battle my personal demons, I can make a whole personnel of humans suffocate in the flames. After life is claimed, difficult name, controlling words in a world with different cults' name. Take significant aim, and even in your past life, you was not harder. You were either a stealer of inventions or a martyr. Every time two mech styles, I
commented. Of Mexican descent, you have either been exiled or fermented. Los Angeles is turning into Gattaca. Load and reload like Metallica. Memorizing Encyclopedia Britannica. If the Pope's afraid to die, then what about you? Even he's afraid of the power of the afterlife crew. Us, like never before, must come back to settle the score. Just a casualty of war. Us, we better for sure. Us, like never before, must come back to settle the score. Just a casualty of war. Us, we better for sure. Like never before, come back to settle the score. A casualty of war. We better for sure. Like never before, come back to settle the score. A casualty of war. We better for sure. Who's the ultimate? No crews can't cope with it. Then they have it to double again. And I hope you know they fit. Bada bada, please be a better rider. Fly fighter when I'm looking for the ladder. Higher, higher, reach big mo. First string from Project Blow. Yo, music do so slow. To the next in the loop, we go. Clipped up with close amigos. We back, we both. Represent the coast. Why trying to get dope, trying to get the dick stuck. I'ma come easy like a quick buck. Keep fucking around, you gon' get cut. Do dirty, ain't no care time. When I'm a fist up. Fist up, you just one victim. I know them thugs one meant for us. I stay getting bit all tough. Laughing at the blood popped up in the world. We get tossed up. All of a sudden, they just wanna put my butt like I'm a fucking elevator. Time and doomsday detonator. No names in the game. Man turn haters, I burn treasures in the clay favor. Wife and man flavor sorted. What you gonna do? Me first show, who your rep couldn't afford.
All right, everybody. I want to thank everyone for joining us. I want everyone to take care, stay safe, and stay faded out there. Peace, everybody.